Yes.
Oh my god.
Oh my goodness.
Jesus Christ. Like a weight off the shoulders. Yeah.
Hi there. Before we get into another episode of Wine for the People, I just want to reach out and say thank you so much for all the amazing feedback that we've had for the change up in the format. Honestly, it's one of our favorite things that our audience is so engaged to give amazing feedback, whether it be positive or negative. It's one of our favorite things. So I just want to give you a bit of a brief rundown exactly why we're doing that. Because first of all, we're actually quite busy at the moment. So we're able to shoot a few more episodes in a day because I'm currently in the winery at Unico's, as you can kind of see. Brendan's overseas doing some amazing stuff at Pro Wine. Henry's done a bunch of fringe shows. He's been very active over this past little bit of time, so we've been really quite busy. So it gives us the freedom to actually shoot a few more videos in one day. And also, what the most important thing is, and what we're really excited about, is that we're going to do a lot more content in the future. Being able to halve our video time to do more podcasts, more deep dives, a whole bunch of other stuff that you guys have been asking us to do, it gives us actually the freedom to do that. So in the future, we'll be able to do so much more content that we're all really, really pumped about. So that's just a brief rundown of exactly why we're doing what we're doing. And hopefully you guys can enjoy the amazing stuff we're really, really excited about to start shooting in the next few weeks after these ferments start dying down and Brendan gets back onto Australian soil. But that's it for me. Enjoy another wonderful episode of Wine for the People. Welcome to another edition of Blind Wine Tasting. I am your host this week, Noah. We're about to taste three wines. We have no idea what they are, where they come from. We don't know the price or anything. What we're here to do is determine how much we like them, how much we'd buy, and what price we reckon this should be. These wines are all supplied to us by the good people at Different Drop. And if you want to give some love back to the show and to the people at Different Drop, check the link below, get onto the Different Drop website. If you enter the discount code WFTP, you get a nice little kickback on all these wines. Now, let's get into tasting these three blind wines, which are apparently all one variety, and we must decipher what variety it is. So let's get into it.
So same, we've got three white wines here, same variety. Pretty classic winemaking.
It's Chardonnay. I hope it is. But that smells flinty and warm and a little bit oaky. I really hope it's Chardonnay. If it's not Chardonnay, then the chances of me getting these varietals right is slim to none. Yeah, I've fallen down this path before, but I still think it's Chardonnay.
Quite like the wine. Really lazy, acidic, textural, quite a lovely, simple wine.
Nice line of acidity. It's got a little bit of oak, but yeah, good quality. Variety. I'm gonna have to try the other two and then see how it goes.
There's no way I'm gonna be able to guess variety here. This is absolutely mental. But I'm gonna go for really hedge your bets, 40. And I want three. Oh my god, I have no idea what's gonna go on here. Jesus Christ.
My number two, they're all green looking. They're all that grassy sort of stuff going on in there. I'm really hoping that it smells like butter and I can land on my Chardonnay pick.
Won't finish that. Oh, okay. Now we're talking. This is starting to smell a little bit more rounded, a little bit more oak, a little bit more lees, like full lees work. It's immediately throwing Chardonnay vibes, but it could be anything but that.
All right, so they're all Chardonnays, like they are. Shardy party, that's it, Shardy. Shard, arrow down, all three, fantastic.
I'm probably leaning more towards Chardonnay so far. Nice stone fruit, some nice ripe fruit characters. Beautiful finish.
They are so different. They are such different wines. This one, like I was saying, it's got that like heat and spice and charred barrel. This just coats your mouth in that. You could tell me that this has milk in it sort of thing. Like it is so, the viscosity of it's different. The way that it wraps your tongue up is completely different.
It's probably all I've got. Well, I'm gonna have to talk about the number of bottles. It is a little bit more serious than the first one, so I probably guess that it would be around the $50 mark. And I would take a couple. I actually think this would age quite nicely.
Yeah, I'm gonna go with Chardonnay across the board here. I'm really interested to see how Henry goes here. That's gotta be really good fun.
God, I'm good. It's definitely Chardonnay. Just definitely is. So with this one here, I think it has got the integration thing going on. So I think it has elements of both of the first two wines, but I think this is going to be the one that's more up to my speed, which is why I put my sunglasses on so I can imagine that I'm on some sort of like lovely riverfront restaurant looking out over the promenade and enjoying a fine glass of Chardonnay.
Yeah, this one's right up my alley. It kind of has a sort of like orange pithy character on the palate, which I really like. Gives it a bit of structure. crumb, and it's really moorish. So I would, this is probably my wine of the lineup. I would take 6, and I'm guessing it's about $38.
All right. If this is not Chardonnay, fuck me, I'm gonna eat my hat. I really like this too. Really good. I'm going 6 bottles because I think that's more my,
You know how you scorch the top of it with your chef's torch or whatever? So that's where like the charred characteristics of the oak are coming out, but then you've still got the creaminess of the creme in the creme brulee. And that's exactly what this wine tastes like. And it's sick. I love it so much. Give me a dozen and I'll pay $70 a bottle for it. That's like a occasion wine for me. That would be something that I'd bring out and like freak people out with. That's really cool.
Alrighty, another 3 wines. Now, we were just chatting off air because we are all aware of the bracket is we have to guess the variety.
Yes.
And Laura, you were just like, the amount I hear about Chardonnay on this show, what variety do we think this is?
It's gotta be Chardonnay.
If it's not Chardonnay, I'm not gonna say I'm gonna retire from the show, but like, this has to be Chardonnay.
Wine number 1 was, out of the 3, definitely the weakest.
Okay.
Did you? Ooh, okay. So you have a different opinion, Laura. What do you got?
Oh, I just, similar to your comments about oak, but I just found on the second one there was a bit more presence of oak, which
interesting.
I didn't like as much. I like the minerality in this wine. Mm-hmm. I think the giveaway across the board that I use Chardonnay is because of the oak use across all 3.
Yeah.
But I think it's been good quality and good use of oak. In all 3 wines.
This is the thing, every time I drink wines like this with you and Brendan, you guys are like, this is amazing. And I'm like, it is. I don't like it.
Lucky? All right, great. Great. Good That's price. Exactly where it needs to be.
Really good price.
And it was Chardonnay.
Yes. Yes. Oh my God.
Oh my goodness.
Jesus Christ. It's like a weight off the shoulders.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So interesting here, I've not heard of this producer.
I gave the bottle to you because I thought you would. I also haven't heard of the producer before.
From Yarra Valley?
Yeah, no, Yarra Valley, Upper Yarra. So that's probably why it is so flinty and so mineral, is it gets really cool up there. And 2021 was a particularly cool year, banging vintage for pretty much most of the country. Yarra was no exception. So this is The Wanderer, made by Andrew Mark. If you like that more Chablis style, you are a fan of Victorian wines, and it's sub $40. That's really, really good value. So wine number 2. This is where I was like, yeah, we're dealing with 3 Chardonnays here, 100%, because this is what you, like, this is definitely that decadent use of oak. This is that real Burgundian style.
So the buttery thing that's going on in here, what causes a Chardonnay to be buttery? Is that oak?
It can be a number of things. It can be the brightness level that you pick at. It can be what we call batonnage, so stirring all leaves during the maturation process. It can be the length of maturation, and then a big element of Chardonnay is the oak.
I was particularly into it. I love all really balanced as far as the winemaking is concerned. I love that kind of nutty oaky thing. Lockie, what is this?
$30.
Whoa.
Wow. That's cheap. Okay. Well, I had this down at 50, so to
I was see at 60.
At 30. I was at 48.
Wow, that's awesome. Domaine Naturaliste, Margot River Chardonnay.
Margot River.
Wow, that's amazing. I would have thought the next one was Margot River, but that's fucking awesome. $30. Yeah.
That's great value for money.
All right, yeah, Tom, I'm gonna be on the phone with you really shortly. Holy shit, that's amazing. Alrighty, we've alluded to it long enough. Henry.
Man, this is so cool. I really liked this. It's like a creme brulee is what it is to me, because you've got like the char from the oak, which is the like chef torch top of it, and then you've got the butteriness of it.
What did you think, Laura?
Yeah, this was my favorite. I loved it. And I just kept going back to it.
Yeah.
It's got this kind of like zesty minerality.
Yeah, so far the value's been really good. So I'd be jumping on different jobs and grabbing one of each and trying to find your ideal Chardonnay. But I think we are all in agreement. The number 3 is our favorite. Lockie, what do we got? 58.
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
That's still good price.
Yeah.
Tasmanian
Chardonnay.
Do you know who the winemaker of this is?
No.
Peter Dredge.
The guy who won Wine of the Week last week. Oh, he's probably the best winemaker in Australia, honestly.
Oh,
the man's unstoppable. This is insane. This is insane. And like, we've tasted his Dr. Red Chardonnay on the show as well, and it's such a departure in style. How good is this?
So we're just in the Dredge hive now. Like, we're the sort of people that someone says bad things about him online and we attack the person. Like, how dare you? He's the greatest winemaker.
Yeah, so I think we're all in agreement. That's probably the way. Yeah, no brainer. Get all 3. They're all awesome. Chardonnay's the best.
Different drop. Has good wines. Who would have known?
And we'll see you again next week.
See you guys.
See ya. Let's jump. What?